The Pampanga River Basin or PRB and the Pampanga River Basin Flood Forecasting and Warning System, PRBFFWC or PRFFWC. Pampanga River Basin is situated in the central plains of Luzon. It transcends the administrative jurisdiction of 11 provinces. However, roughly, an aggregate 95% of the basin encompasses almost the whole province of Nueva Ecija. About a third of Tarlac, two-thirds of Bulacan, and almost whole province of Pampanga. Within the basin are two major reservoirs, the Pantabangan and Angat Dam.
Pampanga River Basin is bounded by the Sierra Madre Mountain range on the east, Caraballo Mountains on the north, the Agno River Basin on the northwest side, the Zambales Mountain range on the west, which includes Mount Pinatubo, and the basin drains towards Manila Bay on the south. Mount Arayat protrudes almost at the center of the basin. Pampanga River Basin is the fourth largest basin in the Philippines next to Cagayan River Basin. Mindanao River Basin and Agusan River Basin in that order. More than 80 municipalities and 7 cities are either partly or within the basin coverage. The Pampanga River Basin drains an area of 10,434 square kilometers, including the river sub-basin of Pasac-Guagua. The average annual long-term rainfall is around 2,150 mm and more than 80% of it is concentrated during the months from May to October. This map shows the principal rivers within the basin. Main Pampanga River has an estimated channel length of more than 260 kilometers. The major tributaries and sub-basins includes the Rio Chico, Coronel, Peñaranda, and Angat Rivers. The Pasac-Guagua River sub-basin is an allied river system that supports the Pampanga River, which is situated at the southwest end of the Pampanga River Basin. It drains an area of around 1,371 square kilometers and was affected by the eruption of Mount Pinatubo in 1991. Principal rivers within the Pasac-Guagua River system includes the Abacan River, Pasig-Potrero River, and the Porac-Gumain River. There are numerous flood mitigating structures within the basin. This includes the famous Mega Dike, the Capiao-Candaba Floodway, and the Arayat-Apalit Setback Levee. The need for a flood forecasting and warning system for Pampanga River Basin is due to the following issues. At least 1 to 2 floods experienced in a year, frequency of tropical cyclone of about 5 every 3 years, pronounced southwest monsoon, relatively low and flat terrain, narrow, silted, and shallow waterways, especially at the lower sections of the main river, 2 swamp areas, the San Antonio Swamp and the Candaba Swamp, 2 major dam structures, the Angat Dam and the Pantabangan Dam, and the reported slow sinking of Pampanga Delta. Other problems within the basin include deforestation, degradation of watershed, which increases river sediment load, degradation of water quality due to industrial discharge, sedimentation due to the eruption of Mount Pinatubo, lack of irrigation water and overuse of groundwater and saltwater intrusion. The flooding situation in the Pampanga River Basin. Here are scenes of some flooding within the basin during Typhoon Kadiang in 1993. River overflowing, flash floods at upstream sections, dam reservoir releases under crucial situations, since during Typhoon Pedring in 2011. Flooded areas in Bulacan and Nueva Ecija provinces, Zaragoza in Nueva Ecija, and Hagonoy in Bulacan. Typhoon Santi in 2013. And the usual high tide at the lower section of the basin. The Pampanga River Basin Flood Forecasting and Warning Center, or PRFFWC. The Pampanga River Basin Flood Forecasting and Warning System is the pilot flood forecasting and warning system in the Philippines. As grant assistance from the government of Japan, it started its operation in late 1973, and operation center was originally based in Quezon City. On March 19, 2009, the center of operation was transferred to the city of San Fernando in the province of Pampanga through another grant aid provided by the government of Japan. First is to bring flood information and warning services of the Pampanga River Basin Flood Forecasting and Warning Center closer to its served communities, and second, to be more abreast with the current situation within the basin. The present Pampanga River Basin Flood Forecasting and Warning Center system is composed of 18 rainfall and 10 water level stations within the Pampanga River Basin. It operates via telemetry system using the microwave frequency. The center is run and operated at present by few regular personnel, shifting schedule on 24/7, 365 days in a year of hydrological monitoring. The center coordinates with the Flood Forecasting and Warning Section of Hydromet Division of PAGASA with regards to flood forecasting and warning for dam operations of Pantabangan, Angat, and Ipo Dam. Monitoring of basin starts with its rainfall station at its upstream most part in Gabaldon, Nueva Ecija, situated at the eastern side of the basin within the Coronel River sub-basin. On the northeastern part of the basin, Pampanga River starts after the Pantabangan Dam. Coronel River eventually joins Pampanga River before Barangay Sapang Buho in Palayan City, Nueva Ecija. This is a view of the present Sapang Buho rainfall and water level telemetry station. Pampanga River then widens up as it passes through Cabanatuan City at Valdepuente Bridge. Several kilometers downstream of Pampanga River, the Peñaranda River, monitored by the Peñaranda Rainfall and Water Level Station coming from the mid-eastern part of the basin, joins Pampanga River prior to the rainfall and water level monitoring station at San Isidro in Nueva Ecija. Meanwhile, at the northwest section of the basin, the Rio Chico River drains the Talavera and Ilog de Baliwag rivers, including the San Antonio Swamp, and at this point is being monitored by the Zaragoza Rainfall and Water Level Station. At midstream part of the basin, Rio Chico River joins with Pampanga River before Arayat in Pampanga. The river at this juncture is already draining more than half of the basin. Here is a view of the Pampanga River at Arayat at a relatively high stream flow situation. Meanwhile, the Candaba Rainfall and Water Level Station, situated at the lowest part of the Candaba Swamp area, monitors the swamp water level during flood situations. Here are various swamp flood water levels recorded at Candaba Station. The Sulipan Rainfall and Water Level Station at Tapalit is the last monitoring and forecasting point for the main Pampanga River at its downstream section. On the other hand, Mexico Rainfall and Water Level Station, which monitors the Abacan River and the Sasmuan Rainfall and Water Level Stations, are two of the three monitoring stations that are in place for the Pasac-Guagua sub-basin area. Whenever flooding, due to overflowing of rivers within the basin is imminent and likely to affect communities along the river's channel, flood advisories, and flood bulletins, and other related information are issued by the center. This information are shared and disseminated immediately and directly through various means to the regional disasters, risk reduction in management councils or RDRRMC, regional office of civil defense or OCD, to the National Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Council or NDRRMC, and to the Hydromet Division of PAGASA. It follows that this information are forwarded by respective entities downwards. The center on its next tier of dissemination activities then provides the information to the respective provincial disaster risk reduction and management councils, to some city, municipal's DRRMCs, and some barangay DRRMCs whenever requested and necessary. Other recipients on its third tier level includes other regional offices, the tri-media and requesting public individuals or entities, eventually leading down to the community. Information feedback with recipient is also carried out whenever possible. The mode of information sharing and dissemination include direct fax and telephone calls through emails and updating of center website. Through social media such as Facebook and Twitter. Direct handling of information to the RDRRMC is done when all means of communication are temporarily down or out of order. Aside from its regular operational monitoring of hydrological situation of the basin, other activities of the Pampanga River Basin Flood Forecasting and Warning Center includes as follows. Hydrographic activities such as river cross-sectioning, river velocity measurements, and other related river surveys are carried out whenever possible. Conduct hydrological researches, post-flood event surveys, area mapping, and others whenever able. Do data quality control and analysis. Enhancement of its flood forecasting and warning system through development of simple forecasting models, settings and adjusting of threshold values, and river assessment levels, updates, and other related matters. The Pampanga River Basin Flood Forecasting and Warning Center actively supports community programs such as the establishment of community-based flood warning setups or local flood early warning systems within the basin and even outside the basin area. In support to its information dissemination activities, the center partners with other regional national entities on information, education and communication drives related to flood hazard awareness and mitigation. Training programs, seminars, workshops, and even conferences within and outside basin of concern. The center accommodates information sharing through popular media such as guesting in regional TV and radio programs, especially during flood event situations. Participates in flood scenario activities such as flood drills and mapping. The center, as the brains behind the program, started through support of DRRM partners and has actively participated and promoted NetFlows, or the Network of Flood Warning System in the Philippines. The center has also been an active advocate of its concept program on the school-based DRRM activity, the SHINE, or School Hydrological Information Network. The said program has been chosen as one good practice in both disaster risk reduction, or DRR, and climate change adaptation, or CCA, activities by Oxfam, with the underlying idea that disaster awareness begins in school. The center was also responsible in coming up with the first PAGASA River Basin Center's conference workshop in 2017. Committed to serving the communities, not only within its basin of concern, but also throughout the country, The PRFFWC, as the pilot flood forecasting and warning center in the country, has continued to remain and will always remain as the main lead flood forecasting and warning center of the Philippine Atmospheric, Geophysical, and Astronomical Services Administration, or PAGASA.